In the last video, we uploaded our program to the Mosaic Safety Controller and tested it using the real-time monitor. And while that worked fine, there were a couple issues with it. First, it was kind of hard to watch the 2-second audible alarm because it went by so fast. Second, we were using our expensive hardware as a test platform. And while that isn't a big deal in a simple example, in a more complex real-world system, that could be a very expensive and unsafe practice. And finally, it requires taking the machine offline while you test it, another expensive proposition. The good news is the Mosaic Safety Designer software has 2 built-in simulators that you can use to verify your program before uploading it to the real hardware. The schematic simulator looks a lot like the monitor that we've been using, except it gives you control over the inputs. The graphical simulator generates a graph of how all the signals respond to a script file you create. You will almost always want to use the schematic simulator because it's so quick and easy. I'm mentioning the graphic simulator here just so you know it exists. Both simulators allow you to view signals no matter how fast they occur, avoid testing on hardware, and don't occupy your system while you're testing. In this video, we'll use the schematic simulation to simulate the system we developed in the previous video. So a quick recap. If any of these are used, then the output should turn off and issue a 2-second signal to an audible alarm. And if either of these are used, then a 5-second signal is issued to an indicator. Once you've verified the program, skip over the connect and upload buttons and go here to the schematic simulator. This looks a lot like the monitor that we've been using, but now there's red dots on everything we can manipulate. So click on these to release the e-stop, let go of the light curtain, and step off the safety mat. And click on this guy to reset the outputs. So far, it looks like it's working exactly like the monitor, except for one thing. All the functions that use timing are dimmed out. Well, that's because we haven't started time yet. Let's hit this green arrow button to reset the simulation and start fresh. To run a simulation with timing, you just hit the green play button and you'll see all the time-sensitive blocks are now active. Let's clear all the devices and reset the output. Now if I press the e-stop, I see the audible alarm signal reset after 2 seconds. Perfect. I'll clear the e-stop, reset the system, and trip the light curtain. Again, we see the 2-second audible alarm, and now we see the 5-second indicator. Let's clear the light curtain and reset the outputs. So this works exactly like the demo we did on the real hardware in the previous video, doesn't it? The only difference is, now we control the inputs here and we're not occupying the hardware. And look at this. You can single step through the timing. All we have to do is select how much time each click of the mouse represents. It defaults to 100 milliseconds. For our example, let's have each click be 1 second, which is 10 times the default. Now if I click on e-stop, everything that isn't time dependent propagates through. Now I'm expecting this monostable to generate a 2-second pulse. So I'll click on the single step button once, I see the time increment 1 second, and the status output goes active for the duration of that 1-second click. Click again, it stays active for the duration of second number 2, and click again, and it turns off now that 2 seconds have expired. Exactly what we expect. Let's release the e-stop and reset the output. Again, everything not dependent on time responds immediately. Now this is really important. When we reset the outputs, the status signal turned on, and normally the monostable would see that transition and reset itself. But no time has elapsed yet, so the monostable hasn't acted on the change. And if we went and triggered the light curtain right now, it would take the status back down, so when we did increment time, the monostable would have completely missed the positive transition and not reset itself. So it's really important that we increment time while the status is on so the monostable sees that transition. So I'll click the single step button once so the monostable can reset itself. Now when we trigger the light curtain and increment time, the monostable sees the new status transition and can react accordingly. And we see that the audible alarm output becomes active for the 1 second, and now the indicator light signal also becomes active for that second. Click again for second number 2, and click again to exit second number 2 and enter second number 3. The audible alarm is done, but the indicator is still active. Click number 4, click number 5, and click number 6 sees the indicator signal turn off because 5 seconds has expired. Well, that's it. That's all there is to running the schematic simulator. This is my favorite feature of the Mosaic Safety Designer software because I can completely design and test my safety program before I buy any hardware. And since the Mosaic Safety Designer software is a free download at AutomationDirect.com, I can try it before I buy it, which makes my buying decision risk-free. Click here to learn more about the Mosaic Safety Controllers. Click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free award-winning support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.